Welcome back to SpreadsheetPoint.com. In this brief video, I will show you a quick stock portfolio tracker that I've created, which you can use and or replicate to how you see fit. So I'm going to go ahead and delete this. Actually, I want to show you how this actually works. So the data columns that you're going to need are pretty straightforward. The name of the stock and the ticker symbol, the buy date, the buy price, the quantity of the shares that you bought, and then these columns here are automatically calculated. That's why I highlighted them in purple. The total invested is simply going to be the buy price times the quantity. So 250 times 5 in this case. Now the current price is going to bring up automatically based on the ticker symbol that you enter in. The current value is going to take the current price times the number of shares that you bought. So it gives you your current value. And then it uses the current value and bumps it up against the total invested, which gives you, of course, a gain or loss in dollars. So let's put these tickers in here. So let's put an APPL. Now, currently you get an error here. Tesla, TSLA, and AMZN, I think. This is where the magic happens with Excel. Let's highlight all of these tickers. And then you're going to go to data, stocks. So you're going to change this data type to stocks. What it does, it will automatically bring in the ticker symbol for these particular stocks. And you can click this button to get instant access and information about the stock itself right there in front of you. So you don't have to go looking around on the internet. And this column here, this function looks at this data now that it is a stock data type and brings in the current price. Let's say we decided to buy some Bank of America stock. So now the stock, the ticker is BAC. Hit enter and it's going to look that right up for you. Since all of these are in the data type of stock, and then it brings in the current price just like that. And that is all dynamic. We're going to buy it on today. We bought it. Let's say we bought it at $50 and we bought 50 shares. So that is of course a loss because the current price is 46. We bought it at 50. That's why this one is a loss as well. Amazon, the buy price is 2,800 and the current price is $223. So that really doesn't make sense. Let's just say we bought it at 250. It makes it a little bit, makes more sense. And then if you wanted to have a number at the bottom here to show how much you've made overall, you can just write a sum function, which sums the gain and loss. And then you can go ahead and add maybe some conditional formatting here. If I wanted to show visually the losses, you're going to use the highlight rules, less than zero, light red fill, just like that. Okay, so let's change this Amazon. Let's say we bought it. Current price is 223. Let's say we bought it at 200, and it's going to show that that's no longer a loss. Lastly, make sure you refresh your data. You're going to go to data and then refresh all, and you're going to see these prices dynamically change. See how they changed? This automatically updates as well each time you open up the file, so you won't have to worry about it. And then you just track your stocks accordingly, and using the data stocks data type, it can automatically bring in the total price. There's a lot of different data as well that you can get from here. If you just click on this little button here or right click, and then you can go. So you're just going to go, oh, here it is. Click on this button here and you can see all of these functions, which will show. You can see the 52 week high and it will actually show right over here. So this could be your info column and you hover over the cell, choose what you want, description, and it puts it right there as info. Okay. I hope you found this video useful. For more information and helpful hints, please visit SpreadsheetPoint.com and don't forget to like and subscribe.